Hi everybody, welcome to the Debt Killer blog for today. Today we're going to be covering bankruptcies, those really awful things that everybody believes you just can't get off of a credit report. I've been doing this type of work since somewhere in the middle, early 80s, and I've heard people tell me all the time, well, I've heard you can get bankruptcies off, but you can't get everything else off, like late payments and charge-offs and all of that. I've heard that you can get charge-offs and late payments off, but you can't get bankruptcies off. You know, the fact is, a negative is a negative is a negative is a negative. You can get any negative item off of your credit report if you're willing to spend the time, do a little work, and wait it out a little bit. I'm telling you, anybody can. I'll give you a good example. I had an individual once had a bankruptcy for $4.6 million. And that's not all. He had a $10,000 tax lien and a whole slew of other garbage on the report. You know, all those things when you file bankruptcy, all those other creditors put all the charge-offs and all the lates and all that was already piling up. All of that's there on the report too. So his report was just a mess. 87 days later, bankruptcy, $4.6 million, gone. $10,000 tax lien, gone. Most of the other crud on the report was already gone too. I think we had a charge off and one or two items we still had to work on a few months later. But that gives you an idea of what can happen. Look, I'm not going to tell you it's going to come off that quick. On the contrary, negative items, I'll tell you here that, well, you'll get all this stuff off, but just as soon as I say that, you'll be the person that'll take a year. But you know, when people ask me about how long it's going to take, and I say, well, you know, it could take 2 or 3 months, it could take 6 months, it could take a year or more. What's the alternative? The alternative is sitting there on your thumbs for 7 years, or like a Chapter 7 bankruptcy for 10 years. And that isn't all, because when you have negative items, the creditors turn it over to a collection company. It shows back up in your report again. So your 7 years start all over again. And then the creditor sells it a year, the collector sells it a year or two later, and that new collector puts it on your credit report all over again. And so the 7 years starts all over again. So you can end up having just a little charge off on your report for 10, 12, 14 years. Look, it's not legal, it's not right, but that is what happens. So when we talk about bankruptcies, let me tell you, bankruptcies can come off your report just as quick and easy as anything. So don't let the big old bad stigma of bankruptcies bother you. They can come off. It's just a matter of some good, honest, hard work and watching what's on your report and checking for everything to make sure that you find those items on your report that are wrong. And then you challenge that item on the credit bureau, on your credit report, to the credit bureau with the information that's incorrect. That's all it is. There's no magic formula other than that. The difference of why a person doesn't do credit repair themselves and uses another company? Well, you know, we've got some good companies on Debt Killer Blog that we recommend. But why go to them versus do it yourself, or maybe purchase our step-by-step guide to cleaning your credit? The difference in doing it yourself versus using another company usually has to do with folks are too intimidated. Too busy. You know, if you're a fancy doctor, a lawyer, or you know, you're just a general old Joe guy, man, you've got a long, you know, you work 8, 10, 12 hours a day. The wife's working a lot of hours. You're blue collar guys, and you come home and, you know, you're just wore out. My dad worked for Southern Pacific his whole life, and he got home, he wasn't about to do anything like credit repair. Not that he didn't have to, but the point is that you just don't have the time. You come home and you sit down to dinner, you know, chat with the wife a little bit, watch a little TV, read the newspaper, and it's time to go to bed. Shovel the kids off into the bathroom, take their bath, and put them into bed. And then the next morning, it's up all over again. And what came up Saturdays on your day off? It was out mowing the grass and doing the yard and doing all those manly things around the house. And the wife, well, that's a full-time job I wouldn't want. The point is, a lot of times people just don't have the time or the inclination to do it, or they're too intimidated. And especially when you start thinking about bankruptcies, everybody gets all nervous and scared. So that's the reasons why. It's like changing the oil in your car. I've used that reasoning a lot of times. Changing the oil in your car, you go down, you can buy all the gaskets and the wrenches and all those different things, and the quarts of oil and filters and the gaskets and all, and you can go out here and spend a better part of a really hot day underneath the engine of your car. Or you can just carry it over here to the Jiffy Lube, and for $19.95 or whatever it costs now, $21.95, $29.95, have somebody else do it. That's what I do, and at Jiffy Lube on my truck, and 15 minutes later, I'll get myself Dr. Pepper out of the machine, and before I can finish it, they're done. They've changed all the oil, they've changed all the filters, they've done all their magic they're supposed to do, they've done a few other checks on it, and I'm out the door, and I'm still driving down the road drinking my cold Dr. Pepper. So that's what I think the reason is that people use a service as opposed to doing it themselves. You've got to decide what's best for you. If you're already working on it yourself, let me tell you, don't quit. Just keep plugging away and keep working on it, and you will get the results, I promise you. Just don't quit. If you're using a service, well, just make sure you keep up with what's going on. Keep records of everything, and you'll get the work done that way too. Well, anyway, I want you to go to the Debt Killer blog. Look at the bankruptcy post that's there. It's under the credits section on the right-hand side. If you need to order credit reports, check out one of the links there where you can order your reports. If you need a credit repair service, take a look at some of the ones we've got there. If you're interested in doing it yourself and you don't know where to begin, we've got a great little book. It's called The Step-by-Step Guide to Cleaning Your Credit. Really simple, very detailed, but very, very easy. Check out our item too. We make our money from the affiliate little things on the website, and we take donations that help us. And everything else we do all comes from the donations that people give us. So click the donate button and make a donation of what you feel is right. I appreciate it very much for everything you guys do. Thank you for taking the time to listen to the video. You guys take care, and we shall see you later. Bye-bye.